What's going on, y'all? Defender32 here. In this video, I'm going to be showing you all the memories that you have to recover to get the trophy in this game. I don't know how many times I played through this game. I played through like 10 times probably. I'm trying to get the trophy. I'm working. I'm grinding to get this platinum. But I only have two trophies left, and that's to get the... to kill Suzanne and to find all the memories. Now, I played through this game so many times, I actually found them. So, I'm also going to show you how to kill Suzanne too, if this works correctly. Now, I know there is one dang old memory that I've missed sometimes, and it's the calendar one. I don't get why, but I believe you're supposed to check the calendar every time that you get the chance, such as over there. Every time you come in this room, check the calendar. And that should unlock it, because sometimes I tried to get the calendar, like when I replayed the game, because you know there's no save points, it wouldn't pop up for me. But that is a memory as well. So what I'm going to do is, in this video, I'm going to view the calendar every chance that I get and see if I can unlock the memory for that.
White wall tires and a three martini lunch.
And it should, now, you should be able to get it when you try to decide if you want to eat the cockroach or not. But the first memory is right here, the paper. I'm just going to pick it up whenever I can.
Wow, almost ready for the triathlon.
Your decisions don't affect the game either. They don't affect what memories you acquire. It's only if you want to become the wendigo or not. Which I'm just going to collect now, since I'm right here. Basically, this note is talking about what the patients are, or what the patients are experiencing. And I don't have the voice on for this one. I'm just going to say, I think I remember something.
Is that so?
I did record my first time playing through this as well. My first impressions. Scary game. Jump sometimes. But, actually, I'm going to start by looking at this calendar now. I've already unlocked this trophy, but to unlock the memory, you're supposed to look at it, I believe. Second one you're going to get is going to be a leaf here. It's going to be later in the game. The third one is going to be a cup right here. I believe the fourth one is the calendar one. Then there's one here where you look through the bars. Then there's one when you have to have the flashlight. I'll show you. I also try to put the time stamps of where I've gotten the memories in the description box. So, just hang in there. So, by the time I post this, I'm going to go back, figure out where each memory I acquired, and I'm going to put it in the description box so you don't have to watch this whole video. Because that's really time consuming. I'm making this video for y'all, so I want to do this as fast as possible without any editing. So, that's our first memory.
Did you find a piece of paper with my notes scribbled on it? Did you read my notes? Well, they weren't meant for prying eyes. Just messing around, really. Appreciate if you didn't tell anyone about this, okay?
I'm gonna tell everybody.
Hey, no one's gonna believe a word out of your mouth. You're in here for a reason. Remember? Oh. Well, I guess you wouldn't. Oh, really? Ha! The guy can get pretty wound up in here. Anyway, I owe you one. Let's get you ready for bed. Lights out soon. All right. Lights out.
Now, in order to kill Suzanne, I believe, is to make her... Okay, I'm closing my eyes right here. This part scares me every time, so I'm just going to walk my eyes shut. Snap, that didn't scare me anyway. Open my eyes when I thought it was over.
Hey, bud. Just follow me. Come along.
Alright, I'll follow you. Your second memory is going to be right there where that leaf is on the window.
Good morning to you.
I already know who that is. Good morning.
You should know we are very encouraged. You're on the road to a complete recovery.
You can't treat me like this! Someone get me out of here!
Of course, there are always going to be patients that are beyond our help. But I know that you only want to get better. Maybe you should meet your new roommate.
Real quick, I'm going to view this calendar.
Genius, you can stare at the calendar all you want. Not gonna make the days go any faster. Only trick I know for that is sleep. Lots of.
All right, now I'm gonna view this memory right here, which is the leaf.
January 29th. February is almost upon us. It's a leap year. We'll have a whole extra day. Who knows how we'll spend it? They always said you can do things on a leap day you can't on any other. Like a woman proposing to a man. Is that crazy?
You're acting like you'd actually seen something unusual out there. All I see is snow or trees. Or were you just daydreaming? Ah. Well, that's a fine way to pass the time around here. Commune with your thoughts.
Maybe you want to eat this sandwich too to unlock the cup. I've always eaten the sandwich. I just don't know. You never would know what to expect from this game. How many freaking playthroughs I have done.
What brings you to this fine establishment? Not the trusting kind, eh? That's fine. But don't worry about me. Memory like a sieve. So, these treatments, they ever get any easier? I hope you're on the level. Name's Gordon. You?
I think I want to pick this one.
I guess the pain don't let up. I'm gonna grab some shut eye. Talk later.
Come on. There we go. Should be good now. All right.
Hey, buddy. You all right? You were shaking the sheets a little last night. Yikes. Well, maybe it won't be so bad if you say it out loud.
I'm gonna see if I can do
gentlemen.
Did I make parole?
You're not a prisoner. Bragg's looking into your case personally. For now, I get comfortable.
God damn it, Victoria. What do you make of her? You think she's on the level? What you got against her, buddy?
I see someone was hungry. Very, very good.
A fake peanut butter jelly sandwich. That's what it looks like.
Give it up. You want out of here. Man. Screw this voluntary nonsense, right? The hell happened that landed you in here? You don't give off that rubber room vibe, you know? Who were you on the outside? You don't have the people in this little slice of heaven. So you, you really don't remember anything? Not by choice. That's for damn sure. I don't want to talk about it right now.
Come on. I'm just really, really hoping that this thing will load for me, because last times I have not. I've checked the calendar, just not every time that I was given the chance to. Third memory's right here. The cup.
Damn it, Victoria. When the hell am I getting out of here?
I'm sorry, I don't...
You told me you would have an answer.
Brad wants you here. Just a little bit longer.
You tell Bragg that I'm done. I voluntarily choose to leave.
Fine, okay. I'll let him know.
Trust anyone in this damn snake pit. Right? You don't trust a word they say either, do you? Then maybe we should tell them what they can do with their damn treatments. Once a week around here, they'll have them doped and drooling in no time. What the hell else could it be?
What? Are you serious? I should be able to view this, but it's not letting me view it. That's weird. I should review it right here. Does not let me do it.
Yeah, this is serious. I need a minute. Let me just think about this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. No. Here it is. I don't know if it's a bug in this game or what. Let's see if I can dang on. Get this right. The ship let me view it. That's a memory right there. I never had a problem with this one.
Yeah, this is serious. I need a minute. Let me just think about
this. Are you serious, man? Are you serious? Oh. See? This is crazy. It let me view it. You see that? It took a while for it to pop up, but it eventually did.
Slow and steady wins the race.
Oh yeah. Number 3.
All right, that's it. Lights out.
Do I want to go in there or do I not want to go in there? No, I don't think I want to go in there. I'm not going in there. Not this time.
There are always going to be patients that are beyond our help.
Okay.
You understand I want what's best for you.
This is the part right here, I believe, where you can get the fourth memory looking through the bars of the door.
For 2 days. They'll be back for me soon. They will be, right? Yes, of course. They can't just leave us here. It's not legal. Jesus, you look like you're right on the edge. I don't know about you, but I'm famished. I'm sure there's still some food around here. Any little scrap will do.
Yep, here it is.
Hey, get off of me!
Why there's David right there. I'm just now noticing that's David.
Come here. I think I got something. Ah, look at this. So got it, Gordo. You have no idea how hungry I am. Who knew that under the right circumstances, stale bread could taste like caviar? And don't you worry. Bragg will have this whole mess sorted before you know it. I suggest you rest up. Save your energy. He'll be around for us soon. Yes? What is it? Those sirens go off when a patient gets loose. They had a whole group of unruly cases come in recently. Unhinged, really. My bet it's one of them. Blackwood staff can handle a loony on the loose. And we're on top of a mountain in the middle of winter. Nobody gets far when it's 40 below. Bragg will sort things out. He always does. You okay? Yeah, me too, actually. Ever since they put me in. Listen, this is gonna be fine. Trust me. Just hang in there. I'm bushed. Why don't we both get some rest? Sweet dreams.
Hey! Come here, goddammit! You sniveling sons of bitches! Help! You can't just leave me in here! You can't do this to me! I'm not supposed to be here, goddammit! I can't believe this is happening. Whole goddamn week they just leave me in here. This is Bragg all over. That two-faced son of a whore. He thinks he can get rid of me. Like trash. Well, buckle up, Bragg. I've almost got a brick free with this spoon. It's pretty good, right? Surprise, surprise. You just want to sleep till kingdom come? Well, I'm not going down without a fight. Tom? You kidding? What the hell is wrong with you? Are you trying to get us killed?
Dang. There's no memories here. There's not gonna be many memories for a while. Let's see. What's the next one, I think? I believe it's when you gotta view the calendar. His hand motion in this game is kind of.
Come in. You are finally arrived. I am very pleased. The treatment is working.
Sure of it.
Tremendous progress.
Oh my god, turn that way. Open the door.
I'm worthy. Ah!
make sure I got view his stupid chair.
Don't come in here. It's me.
No, not me. I'm worthless.
Ah, huh? Oh,
it's just you. Look, I'm sorry about hitting you. Things are, they're not right. It's no excuse, but I just want you to understand I didn't mean to hurt you. No, please. I don't deserve to be forgiven. The worst part is, I barely made a scratch. I'd need 100 spoons to get that brick out. It's been a week, you know? You ever gone that long before? Not me. Nobody's heard about starvation was bad, but I don't know how much longer a body can hold on. You? I think it's time to accept our fate. Who has the strength to fight it?
I keep viewing this just in case this thing don't want to work. But you will view this once he offers you the cockroach. That's when you'll be able to view it. He's either going to glow white, let you know you can view it, or he's not going to do anything. That's what I really hate.
30 men. Down in that mine.
As you can see, I had trouble with that cup. It wasn't lighting up. And then after a while, it lit up. So I'm not sure what goes on with this game sometimes.
Out of the frying pan. And then... leave it to Bragg to hear opportunity knock and know how to cover his ass. You never really have to think about what you might be capable of. Down in the mine, stuck in a cell. What's the difference? We're all alone and hungry. Good question. And what's the point of hiding it now? I mean, really? Who are you gonna tell? I'm not really a... What the hell was that? Time to eat. I saved one just for you.
This is the part here.
So calm outside. It's almost peaceful. I used to think I'd spend the rest of my life on this beautiful mountain. I just thought I had a lot more of it left. Look at us. Neither of us should be here. And yet here we are, eating cockroaches to survive. What are we? There's no one out there, is there? We're the last two people on Earth. And we'll die in here alone.
Yes, done it. There we go. I did it. The one that's gonna give me the most trouble. All of my playthroughs, not of nowhere, all of them are.
Mr. Bragg will start your treatment tomorrow.
So as you can see, that probably did help. That's just a thought that I had to myself, because I know there's a trophy where you could view the calendar as much as you could, and I had got that.
I hope you can understand that none of
and unlocked when I did that, so I thought maybe if I keep looking at it every chance I got, I was able to get it, and luckily I did, as you can see.
It is my fault. And if you can, please.
That's number 5, I believe.
Forgive me?
Yep, 5.
You believe me, right? Thank you for that. I've been here a long time. I've seen a lot of patients come and go. All I ever wanted to do was help them. But this is what it comes to. This. And if I get out of here, it's a new start. Clean slate. People can change, right? Well, I hope so. I hope so. You should get some rest.
All right. Well, sir.
Doesn't feel right.
I played this game so many times, and I still get scared.
God, where have they gone?
First, I'll be playing with the volume all the way up, so when things pop up, open the door. Things pop up, you kind of forget where it is, and the noise scares you. So I just figured out that I did succumb to temptation again, so now I know that I'm going to turn into the wendigo. So I also may need to put that in the title too, based on my decisions that I've made. If it doesn't show him getting wheeled out, that means I'm going to become the wendigo. And if it shows the girl, I'm about to be infected.
Yeah,
I have a lot of stuff in this video then. I'm gonna have to title it Succumb to Temptation, plus all dang on memories, plus how to kill Suzanne if I can figure out how to do that. You do understand I want what's best for you. Gotta close my eyes again, because I'm not trying to get scared. That thing scared the life out of me at first.
No! Why? Why are you
you're doing this! Stop it!
All right, number 6. I'm gonna kill the spider. I thought that was really interesting too. I killed the spider. That's pretty funny. Number 6 is coming up right here, where you have to. Oh yeah, you should have this trophy by the way too. This is done. So once I viewed it the last time, you should have got it. But number 6 is 6 and 7 are in this area. 6 is in here, and 7 is going to be down the hall once you get to the cell that shakes. So you got to view this one.
I'm going to check it out over here.
I'm still in my doctor's office because I was a doctor.
Got him!
The guy with no face. Is the, I thought that was pretty funny. Alright. 6, 7 is down here. Right here, you probably hear it. Where it says William Bates.
We were down there for weeks, starving. Now he's put us in these cages. You gotta help me, Doc.
Number 8 is gonna be in this room. There's a radio you can play with over there if you like to. I did when I first played through the game. 6, 7, 8. It's over here. Just have to walk in and pick up this clipboard over here. I don't know how many collectibles you have to collect, but I do know I know where all of them are by heart, because I literally played through this thing so many times and checked every dang one corner of each part. I just couldn't dang well help it by trying to find these things. But you're done with upstairs after you collect the clipboard, the blank clipboard with nothing on it. Just wait for the elevator to come up, and then there's going to be another one downstairs. And that's when you have to view the little chapel sign. The chapel symbol, or the chapel dang on sign. Now, I think in order to get Suzanne killed, you have to gain her trust and not gain David's trust, I believe, because I've gained both of their trust, and dang on, David ended up trying to save me when the Wendigo was trying to attack me. And you want to go before, you always want to go before Suzanne goes. Because I believe if you go before Suzanne goes and David trusts you and Suzanne trusts you, which I showed in my other video, David will come try to save you and he ends up dying. Spoiler alert, too late for that. But he ends up dying. But I believe if you don't make David trust you and you make Suzanne trust you by agreeing with her to let Brad go with y'all to the chapel, she will probably end up saving you. So I'm going to experiment that now. Hopefully it works, because I'm going to have to start this game all over again. But while I did that, I thought I would help y'all try to, there was nothing in that room. Try to help y'all, figure out where all these dang on memories are, because this game is hard. This game is really hard when it comes to trying to find everything and trying to get the right outcomes, because there's no dang on save points. I had myself going crazy dang on trying to play through this thing so many times, trying to get this crazy platinum trophy. But I put so much time into it, I gotta get it. It's like a must now. Oh, actually, no. Your other one's gonna be in here. I forgot about this part. Your other one's gonna be in here. There's gonna be a mask in there. And then you can view the chapel. So you flip this over. Blackwood Sanatorium, patient file. Alright, and then you will move in here to this next room, not too far away, and if you look on the bed, there will be a, I believe it's a mask to keep the patients from biting themselves, or biting people, or spitting on people, or something like that. It's a type of mask, and you collect it from in here. Which is right here. I'll play this game too much. I play this game too much. There we go. Well, probably a mask to keep them from screaming, I guess. But yep, that's that. And now I believe the next one that you're gonna find is the candle inside the chapel, and there's gonna be a chapel sign you have to look at before you get to the chapel. But of course, I'm going to show you where it is. So I'm just trying to remember each dang on memory in my head.
Stop right where you are. Who are you?
No, I'm patient. I wish I knew. Okay. I'm gonna say that.
Okay.
You must. Because you don't want him. You don't want him to gain his trust.
Be sure you weren't one of those things.
Trust.
Didn't want to freak you out, but I've been keeping my eye on you. Shit. That's one of them. It's close by. Anyone back the way you came?
Not a living soul. Distressed.
Anyone else sticking around, they're on their own, but you better come with me this way.
I don't know what to pick. I really don't know what to pick. But you don't want him to trust you. I know that. Cause dang on, I gave him my trust before and I end up trying to dang on get the other girl to kill herself to save me, and she didn't. Then there was one part when I first played through it. Dang on, I let her go first, and I thought I would have got the trophy that way because the dang on monster killed her, but I didn't get it. So you literally have to go first in order to let the wendigo try to attack you, and then it's going to say don't move, but you want to move. And then depending on who trusts you more, I believe, it's going to tell you who's going to save you. But no matter what, dang on, both of them have your trust. I believe David's going to try to save you. But if you side with Suzanne, like I said, trying to persuade Bragg to come with y'all when y'all go to the chapel, I believe you're going to gain her trust. So, I know I keep repeating myself, just want you to know.
I think we're okay, for the time being anyway. I'm David, I work here. How long have you been in here?
Never mind that, let's keep moving. Okay, here we go.
Why are you alone here anyhow? Everybody already left. You pissed someone off?
Man.
Hey, if you don't want to tell me, so, give it to me straight. You one of the miners from the cave-in?
I'm gonna just not say anything.
You're a real confidence builder, ain't you? Anyway, we gotta keep on. There were other survivors. They're not far. But just so you know, I got my hand.
There we go. Sweet. Okay, so I believe. Okay, let me look really quick at this. Butterfly effect. It should say he does not trust you. Weakness. You succumb to temptation. Bennett was killed in your room. That's not what I want. That's the only one I have though so far. But as you can say, he says he'll keep my eye on you, meaning he don't trust me. So I gained his trust. I'm going to gain Suzanne's trust. Hopefully, she will save me when I tell her to stay back and I go first and get attacked by the wendigo. But, your other one is going to be up here soon.
Everybody else is holed up with Ted in the chapel. I'd be there too, but no Brad. There's always something with him. He had to go back. And Suzanne and I are his escorts. They should be waiting for me in his office. I came out here to scope it out. Watch your step. Take it nice and slow.
Since I'm already this far, I'm going to show you the secret room as well. I'm just going to try to do everything in this video. I'll put it in the description box and all that as well. And the title.
I haven't seen any of the miners since the incident. I still hear them, though. Mostly outside. I mean, I think it's them. Ugh. Gives me the chills every time.
Here, is it? No, so I can't remember. Nope, nothing over here. I heard something last time I walked up here. Like, it's like it came from above me when he opened up the door. Let's see. Guess not.
Brad's office is right down the hall.
All right, so the secret room that you can get to obtain one of the trophies on the trophy list is viewing this tape that's in here, and it is coming up soon.
Brad was not exactly pleased.
Right here, it's gonna be on the left, right beside this wheelchair.
Get your whiffs on, you ain't supposed to.
Not going to show you. If I can find my hand. If my hand wasn't so stupid in this game. Then everything is so dark. Hold on. Okay, my hand is here. And right here. You can't miss this trophy. It even glows when you walk by, but since I'm already showing you everything in this video, I might as well just put this in here just because. But this is a tape you can view. You'll get the trophy. It'll pop up as soon as you hit the button, or while the video is playing, I believe, or after. I forgot what it did for me, but you should get this one. I'm trying to get out of here now.
Oh, damn. Hearing about it's one thing. Seeing it, she was a good lady.
All right.
I hope when the police show up, they plug every last fucking miner they see.
Okay.
And here we are, Head Honcho himself. Hey, it's David. Can I come in? Bragg, Suzanne, got another live one.
As you can see, since I succumbed to temptation,
why the hell would you bring him here?
My roommate is not there because he's dead.
I know what you've done. You're
so this guy's
monster.
Pissed. He's pissed at me because I am becoming the Wendigo. So he's mad at me, calling me a monster and all that.
Patient, how are we feeling today?
Gordon, that's his name.
We were caught off guard. None of this was, it just wasn't how it was supposed to.
Dang. Fussing this dude
nothing
up.
Less.
Hey, do you know who you're speaking to? Jefferson Bragg is a great man who's done great things for a lot of people, myself included.
David, enough. I should never have come back. Sorry, I thought I could right the ship. But you can't steer a ship in a squall.
Mr. Bragg, you've been down before. You'll pull us all through. I know you will.
Oh, Suzanne, my dear.
So, this part, I'm going to agree with her. So hopefully she will come to my rescue when I'm about to get attacked by the Wendigo.
This is,
I really hope this works. Because I'm tired of playing through this late. I'm tired of playing through this game.
I'm finished.
No, Mr. Bragg, please, let's just go to the chapel. The storm's lit up. The police are
yes.
on their way.
To the chapel.
Thank you.
Go now. I'm staying here.
We can't leave you behind. It's not safe. Please. You know we all have to go. Everyone, Bragg included.
Enough. This place belongs to me. And I belong to it. Now get the hell out of here. And take that monster with you.
So about me.
Suzanne, stop. Come on. He's made up his mind.
No. No!
We gotta go now while we still can.
Get out! Leave me alone! Haven't you done enough damage? Is that what you tell yourself? Get the fuck out.
Dang. I didn't hear him say that before. God dang, this dude is pissed. Alright, well, we'll try to help the old dude. He just mad because he old. That's the only reason. Pissed off at me for nothing. Alright. So, coming up, it's going to be the chapel sign. Then it's going to be the candle. You have to view for memory inside of the chapel. Oh, no, 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 no. There is one up here. I'm sorry. There is one.
What do we do to deserve this?
It's up in this room. You're actually going to have to look through a cell. Always come in this room just in case, even though there's nothing in here. But I'm just so used to scanning everything. Used to scanning all the rooms and stuff. But up here to your left, you're going to walk down. Notice how we're starting freezing. I'll make you pay. Stop testing on us now. It's going to be up here to your left. So they're standing here. You should hear some noise coming from this way. And you should be able to walk through. And it's going to be right here. Just look through the bars.
let me go. Just let me go home. I just want to see my family again.
What's up with you? You're as white as a sheet.
All right. Now I believe the next one is inside the chapel, or the next memories are inside the chapel, and where the chapel symbol is. I thought it looks like there would be something in this room, but it's not. I actually thought there would be something in here as well, because there's a paper right here, but this is just a note. There's nothing on it. Pick up the paper, God. Just the paper. Nothing special. Look how slow he's going up these stairs. Come on now. All right, so we're coming up on the part where the wendigo is about to come out. This thing is full of spoilers. Hopefully someone who hasn't played this game yet watches this video, because I'm going to piss them off. But I'll put that in the description box as well. Alright.
Wait. We don't know what's out there.
There was nothing out there before.
Let's just go one at a time.
Before I do this, let me see the butterfly effect. Chance meeting. You were guarded with David. David was suspicious of your motives. Okay, see that part I did manage to, like, avoid his trust. You sided with Suzanne. Suzanne blamed herself for not convincing Bragg to leave. So, as you can see, I've sided with Suzanne, who's a nurse, and she's basically my trustworthy person other than him. What I meant to do.
What's Ted say?
Because I've already killed him before.
Move a fucking muscle.
And you may guess it, in order to kill him, you want to have his trust, and not hers. Even though, when I got it, I had both of their trust.
Okay, I'll go first. When I make it across, I'll give a signal and the next one comes.
Alright, so he hates me, basically, and she likes me. So, who's going to come to my rescue, I'm hoping? Her. So before or after he gets done. Oh yeah, just to also tell you, the next memory is right here. You want to view this chapel sign right here. But as I was saying, when the decision comes, you want to go first. Don't let her go. You have to go first.
You next or am I? Okay, I'll follow.
All right. So, the wendigo is going to come down and is going to say, don't. What the heck? Supposed to be going on.
On the roof.
Oh snap. Okay. Come on, David. Please don't come out. Just want to kill Suzanne. I'm moving. Oh, she did. Oh, she did. Oh, snap. Dang. Get your hands off me. Oh, man. There we go. I'm a smart fella. Well, I just play games too much, one of the two. But one thing I did not do, I did not view this chapel thing. So let me go back and do that. And why is my guy walking so slow? So that's how you kill Suzanne. If you want to know how to kill David, I did post a video or another video showing you how I did that as well. And then I also did one showing you how to kill Ted. But I'm going to tell you at the end. And this is your other memory. My bad, I skipped that. I'm trying to cover so much to try to help as many people out as I can. But yep, that's the other memory you want to get. And I've never done that before. I've never got caught by the wendigo while being like a wendigo myself. As you can see, I had the little thing come up over my face. And they were white. But, I got the trophy. Are y'all gonna let me in? Or I got the trophy for killing Suzanne.
This didn't have to happen.
Your next memory is going to be all the way up there. You're going to have to go up these stairs. That's over here. Either way, it doesn't make a difference. It's going to lead you to the same place. And your memory is going to, you probably can see it glistening.
David,
but it's going to be up there. It's a candle. And that's your other memory.
Things got complicated.
I knew it was too dangerous.
Stop it. Suzanne's dead.
Yes.
So now, in order for me to get my platinum, I just got to dang one, collect all the memories. I know where they all are.
Food.
Just wanted to stick around and watch the walls come down.
Yes. Well, if Bragg had made up his mind, there's nothing on heaven or earth that would have changed it. Think long and hard about the pain you've caused here today. The people you have. I'm glad you made it back here. Not everyone has been so lucky today. The mythology I've been telling you about. The story of these things. I never knew how true it all was. This is not a disease. This is not a virus. This is a curse. There are more survivors holed up in the administration offices. They still think it's an infection. They have no idea what they're up against. They need our help.
God damn it. Why, Suzanne? Why? I can't stand that she's gone.
I'm sorry, David. I know she meant a lot to you. She was a good person. I've been so worried about each and every.
Oh, there it is. Now it's glistening. That's where your next memory is. I'm just trying to wait for him to stop talking so I can go up there and get it.
Powerful. But he wouldn't listen. Said I'd lost my grip. Said there are no such things as evil spirits. I even started doubting myself. But now. We have to wait. Police will be here soon. They have to be.
Alright, I think I'm done. Yeah. Once he says everyone gets shut out, we all break apart normally. So, I'm gonna go up here and get this memory. Up here. I'm not sure what number I'm on. Just as long as you're following this guide and you've collected all the ones that I've collected so far, you should be good without skipping any of them. Look how slow my guy is going up the stairs. Just look at his feet. Look at his feet. Look how slow. This game can get nerve-wracking sometimes because you're like, gosh, I just want to keep going. Just let me move a little bit faster. But, yep. We are here. Finally. This is the next memory. Just look at it. Show Ted and Bragg down there.
There's something bigger than the two of us at work in this place, and we've got to be careful.
Stuff and nonsense. What you're saying is ludicrous.
All right. The next memory is going to be the camera. Now, I think I found this one like in my third playthrough where I've literally searched everywhere. And I just luckily came across it while searching a dead end. Didn't even see it at first. I like walked right past it. And then another playthrough, I was able to find it. Because I went back and it glittered for me. Or it glistened for me. So I'm going to show you that, and that's going to happen after you get shot at by the police. By this door right here. After you rest. It's actually behind this door, but I'm going to take a seat right here. So now I'm going to rest up. The police are going to come. I'm going to open the door. Shot at.
Would you please come and help me?
Ooh, I gotta grab it. Okay, there we go.
I'm so sorry. This will all be over soon. God forgive me.
No!
Damn. And I'm not sure if there's a trophy you can get by being the wendigo, because I know everyone dies. Especially if you kill Ted at the end. But I'm not sure. But I already had that trophy. It just made me think about that now. Because at the end of this, if I do decide to kill Ted, and if Victor isn't alive, I don't know if he will get the trophy then or what. Because basically everyone will be dead. Unless you don't, unless David doesn't.
Wait, go! Go! Keep moving!
In the elevator.
Don't stop!
What the fuck just happened?
Stop! Wait.
Great. Now what the hell do we do?
David, help me with the door.
Yeah. Come on!
All right. So once I wake up, you're going to go to your right, and it's going to be, the camera is going to be inside of the cage.
How are you feeling?
This way.
Service tunnel. Connects to the hotel. You should rest up for now.
As you can see, I'm starting to transform. With your skull. I'm starting to turn.
Hit your head pretty hard.
You can probably see it on my
why would they just open fire like
my hand
that?
As well.
Police saw the miner. What he'd become. And they reacted.
Reacted? People are dead, man. That's a pretty big fucking reaction.
I think we all need to calm down. Think this through.
Oh, shit.
Why would they do that? Open fire. Kill them all. People are dead. People are dead.
That sounds like Brad talking.
Maybe we should turn around. I mean, maybe the police didn't even follow us. We can make a run for the door in the chapel.
I agree. The police know we saw what they did. That makes us witnesses. We have to get out of here.
What's that noise? That's pretty sweet, because that's what Gordon was saying if he was here. Around the same part.
How the hell am I supposed to know? You're looking a little off color. Must have hit your head pretty hard back there.
What? Describe this then.
Weird.
Talk about me hitting my head. Do you not see my skin?
Need to move. Now.
All right.
I think you can stand.
All right. So, instead of going straight like you're intended to go, you're going to come over here, and the camera's going to be right here.
I think you might want to leave this here.
This is Victor.
Don't want to blow your cover. Good luck. Where you're going? Going to need all
I happen to just walk this way, be like, did I find this? Did I come this way before? And it just highlighted. I was like, yes. Man. Oh no, we're gonna start this. This guy's always in my way. Your next one is going to be it's gonna be the I'm not sure.
We should go.
You will collect a newspaper, a clipboard. Oh no, you will collect you will collect the doctor suit, which is the jacket that's going to be in a laundry basket. A newspaper. You're going to have to collect the picture that's in the basement, I believe, of the elevator. And then you're going to collect a picture. And then after that, I believe you will be done. Oh. Also, a liquor bottle. That's going to be in the kitchen. And then after that, I believe you're done. Let's see. Let's see really quick how many memories I've gotten so far. And in this case, even if you... Yeah, a door too. That's also downstairs. So these are going to be coming up. Newspaper. All these are going to be coming up in this chapter. I've already collected all of these, as you can see. But, since it's just save, if you've been following my guide so far, even if you do skip one, you can always come back, because once you resume the game after you beat it, it's going to put you right where you were at first, which is in the tunnel. But I'm going to continue this.
Can we use the cable car now that the storm is over?
Victor keeps most of the place.
I'll show you.
For winter.
I doubt Victor leaves alive.
Victor knows this place like the back of his hand. If anyone could make it, it's him.
So dark. Oh, there we go.
Victor, is that you? Jesus fuck!
All right, show's over. Let's move on. Victor manages to cram the entire hotel in here for the winter. Look how organized. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Sets a fine example.
Please, Ted, we have to stay focused.
Now, if you're viewing this video and you are not the Wendigo, if you hit the wrong button on the elevator and you go to where the police is, they will shoot you. But luckily, it's saved. So if you've missed something, you can just hit resume after the credits roll, and you'll be put back in the same spot. Just be careful which button you push. But since I'm the Wendigo, I'm going to be able to... You'll see. You will see. So that's the newspaper I was talking about. The next one, I believe, is going to be the doctor suit inside of the doctor suit that is inside of the basket, like in one of these baskets. Or is it going to be... I keep stopping because this guy is so close to me. Look, he's always on my back. I thought there'd be something in there, but it wasn't. It's just a dummy room I call. You go in there thinking, oh.
I hope I'm wrong about you. God help us.
I said, she's always in my face.
What the hell is going on here?
I'm afraid we're running out of time. David, keep your wits about you.
Where are we? How far to the elevator?
We're now in the basement of the Blackwood Pines Hotel. The elevator overhead will get...
No, where am I going? The next one is coming up. The next memory is coming up. Okay. If I can tell which room we're in, I can tell you which one we are going, or which memory we're going to be able to get. Okay, so the elevator's here. There's a kitchen on this right side. The next memory is going to be in here, and it is. So, I'm going to go right on this part, and the bourbon bottle is going to be over here. Right here.
That's everything. Well now. Doctor.
I'm trying to toast it up? Okay.
I can only hope you have better luck than the last
one. Oh, I can't turn around.
Hey, has a little knock on your noggin knocked any sense into you? You hear voices? Me too, when someone's talking to me.
Haha, very funny. Alright. Next one is going to be the doctor suit. I'm 100% sure. It's going to be in a basket in a room that is coming up very soon. Around this corner once you go up the stairs.
I can't.
Here he goes. So, this part's to your left. Whoa, flashlight got stuck. To your left, you should see it glowing, and it's going to be the doctor top.
Need one of these. Help you blend in. Try it for size.
All right, so there should be three more. Let's check. Should be the butterfly painting, which is in the basement. There should be the poster that's right above the or on the wall near the little cargo, the thing where you escape from, and the door. 1, 2, 3. Yep, all these other ones we should have collected together. So now I'll show you. We're getting close, everybody. We're getting close. Been a long 2+ hours. Enter the elevator. Quiet. Surprised I didn't see that light.
Got to get out of here.
Help! Well, he got shot.
This is not good.
I don't know if this is true, but I believe if you look at him after pushing the button, he automatically gets shot. Because every time I looked at him, he got shot, and every time I didn't, he didn't get shot. But Suzanne was also living when that happened. I'm not sure. So many different outcomes to this game. It's crazy.
Almost there.
I hit basement, I believe, and we're going up. But once we get up to the top, which is going to be the second floor, this is where the little train thing is. The little ski, call it the ski elevator.
Looks like it got hit by one of the bullets.
There's going to be a memory right on the wall. After you go through that door, go immediately to your right.
Damn.
And there should be a poster right
what
there.
Now?
And that's the memory. And then downstairs, I think it's one. It's one of these. It's two of these. Because the basement is where the picture is. And then I think one or L is the door where Victor would be standing if he was alive. So I'll show you. But we're going back down. This part is crazy. As you can see, I'm turning pale if you look at my skin.
Everyone just calm down.
Starting to turn.
There's no point in panicking. We have to get out of here now.
Down here, there's a painting right over there. It's the butterfly painting. You gotta come back down here after you reach the top. Let's try the basement.
What in God's name are you doing? Police are still down there.
This is how it ends.
Sometimes you hit a button and it'll take you to like the wrong floor over here too. I've noticed that. Come on, screen, don't be doing this. So as you can see, my inner wendigo is kicking in. I know if you come down here, they will shoot you and you'll die. But since I've turned, I'm killing him now. See, they're scared now. They're leaving me. But you see, I'm a beast. I've done all that. And this is the same floor we were on before we all got on the elevator. These were the guys that were standing on the opposite side of that door right there. But Ted and David are going to the second floor. I'm going to try and go to the other floor where the memories are located. Come on, come back down here. Okay, so this is the basement, I'm guessing, where I am now. So I'm gonna go to the lobby. The lobby is where the butterfly painting should be. But we're gonna have to see where this takes us. Yeah, see, it's highlighted. If you're watching this video, you shouldn't care about spoilers anyway. Alright, so as you can see right here, and this is the lobby floor. So the first couple times I played through, I was confused on which floor was which, but this is the lobby floor. This is one of the memories, and I believe there should be two left now after you do this one.
Every single choice will affect your fate and the fate of those.
Oh snap. I'm about to say, I'm one of you. You shouldn't even dang on be afraid of me. But let's see how many memories we have left. Should be two. Yes. This is located by the by what did we escape in, and this is located on the first floor. So we're going to go to the first floor to get the memory of the door to a room. Got to be really careful which button you hit. Sometimes you may hit the wrong button while in the elevator. Right here, and this is Victor. I don't know how he died, but your other memory is going to be right here, room 26.
You seem to be in quite a hurry to go snooping around where you don't belong. When you get back, you can catch some sleep in here. All right, Rastax, this ain't a free ride.
Oh snap. You may never know. You may not want to move when those things are around. Oh. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are on our last... How did I get through the door? We are on our last memory now, and that is going to be located at the top. And I'm also going to show you what you need to do in order to kill Ted, and what you need to do to... become the ultimate sacrifice. Now you can only do one of these at a time, either become the ultimate sacrifice or kill Ted. But do not fear, because whatever you do, you can replay it. So say like if I decide to kill Ted right now, the credits will roll. Once the credits start rolling, if you hit the trigger, the T trigger, not at the beginning of the credits, but when the credits literally start rolling from top to bottom, if you hit the T trigger, you can skip it.
There.
And like I was saying, sadly, David is dead. But in order to get this, memory. You have to go around the corner right here, and this should be it. I should get my platinum. Thank the Lord. This is the last one.
Welcome. Nice to know that all are welcome. Even hot shit reporters. Not a word of me in your story, or there's no deal. All right. Elevator's over here.
Got the gold platinum pop-up, baby. Pop-up. Woo! Got it live on the air, too. Finally got the platinum. But, man, that makes me really happy because I played this thing so many times. But now I'm going to go in here. I'm going to show you either how to kill Ted or to be the ultimate sacrifice. I'm choosing to be the ultimate sacrifice, but I'll show you which decision to make. So I'm going to start off by talking about how to kill Ted. You literally have to threaten him. So you want to hit, I'm not going, you know, I'm not being left here, I'm not a monster, you know. And then over to how to be the ultimate sacrifice, you need to be like hopeless, like saying, what do I need to do? So forth. So in order to kill him, you need to pick that one. But I'm not going to pick that one. I'm going to say, can you help me, Father? Because I'm going to show you how to be the ultimate sacrifice.
I'm sorry. You're beyond help. The curse cannot be reversed. The monster will soon be all that's left of you. But your last moments of humanity need not be in vain.
Like I said, in order to kill him, you want to threaten him. No, I'm not staying. But in order to have the ultimate sacrifice, you want to agree, which would be like, okay, what do I need to do? So I'm going to hit this.
Once I'm in the car, press that button. That'll start it down the mountain.
As you can see,
I'm so sorry this is how it had to end for you.
I'm going to have to push the button in order for him to go down.
Sacrifice will not be forgotten.
So like I said before, you can only do one of these once. You can, like, you know, like, oh, I want to go back and change this. You literally have to either be the ultimate sacrifice or you have to kill him. But whatever you pick, like I said before, just quit the game after the credits roll and then hit resume, and it's going to send you right back to where you're about to go in the elevator, you know, before David gets shot. And you can just basically do whatever you need to do, whether it's to kill him or do the ultimate sacrifice or so forth. But yep, that's basically gonna be the end. And of course, since I'm the Wendigo, you're also going to get that ending of where you are going to see Beth and I forgot the other sister name, but that's going to pop up after the credits roll as well. So you should have the trophy right now, which should be popping up to be the ultimate sacrifice. And you have to wait a little while. Then once the credits start rolling, just skip it by holding the T triggers or pushing the T triggers, and you're going to see the Wendigo trophy ending of the sisters. But yeah, I've shown you a couple of trophies in just that one video. Dang on, I got the platinum, which I'm pretty happy about. I believe I put together a good guide too. Make sure you like this video, comment if you have any questions, and I'll do my best to answer them. Like I said, I made this video for people who need help trying to get extra trophies. Like, a lot of people was asking, how do you get the Wendigo trophy, and how do you become succumb to temptation and all that? So hopefully this video will help. I'll never be free from your smile. Come on, come on. The sweet surrender. And yes, it is a very short game. And it's going to require you to go through the playthrough, like, a lot. Or if you're viewing this video, you shouldn't have to play that many playthroughs in order to get all the trophies. I literally went through almost all of them in this one video. Alright. So now I skipped it. And since I chose the Wendigo path, this should pop up. Which is going to bring us to the release of Until Dawn. February 2014. The original. You can even walk, so right now I'm walking forward. Hannah Beth. That's a pretty good little throwback. But yep, I've shown you everything that I possibly could in that one playthrough. Showed you all the memories, so you should have all these. Showed you how to succumb temptation, and showed you how to get the Conda trophy. All they got to do now is to resist temptation. But thank y'all for watching. Like, subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.